From our guest, Runambi Tamdudi. She's the owner of Luna Cosmetics, and we're talking pursuing passion in fragrances. I want to find out, Nambita, can you hear us?
Hi, yes, I can hear you.
Hi, Nambita. How are you, Sissy?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Let me welcome you to the show. Ndibulele kakhulu that you have been able to accept our request and come through to have a conversation, Nati, about your business.
It's really a pleasure. I'm also
Man,
happy to be here.
yes. Man, I'm going to get you to that you tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got into the world of business.
Oh, okay. So, my name is Nambi Tamdudi from Mount Frayne, Eastern Cape. I studied in Eastern Cape and my varsity also in Eastern Cape, and then but I've worked in different provinces. I've worked in Gauteng, I've worked in the Western Cape, and also a bit in the Eastern Cape. So I worked before I got into business. And I think I started falling in love with, well, I unleashed the entrepreneurship spirit in me when I was in working in Cape Town. And that's where I got introduced to fragrances and cosmetics. And it's something that I have always loved, anything that has to do with beauty. So it was just an easy transitioning from me being a quantity surveyor, working as a QS, into a space that I really, really like and understand.
And those two worlds are so far apart. I mean, they are so far apart. I usually feel like I don't know, no, but I'm climbing the thing. I'll end up as someone who's external with little knowledge. But the thing, no matter when you are in the QSing engineering space, even your outfit cannot really be fancy. I don't know if that's true or not. But obviously, you'll know better. And then liking beauty, I'm sure Nyanik Banzima, you know, how to integrate the two worlds.
Yeah, it was like literally I was one of those girls. I remember before moving to consultancy, I started in construction. I used to wear makeup going to sites, and it
Oh
would
my
be like
word.
35 degrees and I have
You'll be
full
melting.
makeup on site. So it
Oh my word.
was just like, okay, why is she wearing some makeup? Because I've always liked makeup. So, and as much as I worked like in construction, but I used to wear makeup all the time, even on site.
Oh my
So,
word. And I'm sure it
yeah.
would be difficult, hey, because if you wouldn't force your way through, you would literally only have time for Sunday, go off where you can put it on or off days. But I mean, generally, usemsebenzini, so what are you going to do?
Exactly. And in construction, you'd work Monday to Saturday. So the only time off you have is literally Sundays. So I've always loved, it was always, I've always liked beauty. I've always loved makeup, anything cosmetics. I've always loved.
All right. Now let's get into your business. Tell us a little bit about obviously right now I get the sense that your business is not you don't have a physical store as yet, but you will clarify that. You have an online you trade online. Now one can ask the question, Ubana, why choose going the route of online and how have you been able to establish that?
Oh, okay. So we actually do have a physical store. So we started off with Namtata. We at a mall called Betting Abs. We have a kiosk there. We've been with them for about 3 years now, I think. So why did we decide to go online? We actually decided 3 years ago. We've always wanted to go online because obviously you reach a wider market, and you know it's just because when you have physical stores, also you're limited to that area you are at. Yes, it's nice that people can physically come and taste and smell the things, but online, and I mean everybody's moving to the digital space, and there's no limitations with online. And but if you are just physical in one area, you know, you're just limited to that clientele. So I think that's why I have always wanted to go online, so to reach like a wider market, I guess.
So tell me some of the products that you have that you offer, like you've got perfume and what else as part of the cosmetics range that you have.
For now, we just launched last week Thursday, our fragrance range. All our fragrances are inspired by different fragrances. We will be launching in 6 months, though, our lip line. So
Okay.
we are dropping in stages, but for now, it's the fragrances that we have launched.
Let's talk about the design process. I never know. Okay, and as you're talking about the design process, also touch on, are you focused on women, or is there a unisex element to the cosmetics that you're going to be coming to the market? But what I'm more interested in is, choosing colors, creating a brand. How do you know what, like, talk us through that process of choosing between orange and blue. Yes, orange, yes, not blue. What does it mean, and how do you position yourself in the market with that?
Okay, so when I was developing the brand, I was very clear about what I wanted. So I had a plan and I was clear who my target market is, right? So what we wanted to do at Luna is to bring luxury at an affordable price to everyone. So you find that sometimes affordable things don't look luxurious, you know? So we said, no, but everybody deserves luxury. Even our tagline is luxury for everyone. It's actually so funny because it took us 3 years to come up with just the design.
That's why I'm
Just
asking. That's why I'm actually
the
asking.
design. So the colors have to be aligned with your brand. So you're not gonna have colors that are gonna not gonna speak to what you're trying to achieve. So even the font that you use will make a difference in your brand, even the spacing, there's so much. So that's why something that can take you 10 minutes, just like design something in 10 minutes. But there was a lot of back and forth with the designers because it had to speak to what we were trying to achieve. So I don't know how many times we had to put the launch on hold because it was not speaking to our brand. So nude colors we've picked and the whites and the, just like soft feminine colors, but black for masculinity for the guys to accommodate them. And yes, we do fragrances for guys as well. So we've chosen colors that are not too loud, not too, they're classy
Control.
and neutral colors that everybody can relate to. We didn't want anything too loud. Yeah, so that's it's but it's a process. It takes time. It's not something that happens over like a month or two, because a lot of back and forth.
But I'm sure it's a beautiful process that maybe one day you'll get to pen down, if that's something that you would consider. Because I think abanye abantu, who, especially as black small businesses, they don't have an insight into what goes into it. You just have the dream, but I want to have a range, a line, or a brand, in the certain space, but you don't know about the intricacies of the behind the scenes type of process that one has to go through. And I think it's wonderful to have some of us, launching these, so that at least abantu bakwazi to that information, and also to be inspired that bangakwazi, as long as they put their minds to it. Now, where does production happen?
So production at the moment happens in Eastern Cape.
Okay.
So most of the products that we are currently manufacturing, they're insourced. Like we do the production ourselves,
Sure.
but not all our products are going to be insourced. Some are going to be outsourced. But currently now we are producing everything in Eastern Cape, in Montfrey.
That is good.
Yes.
That is very, very good.
Yeah.
And when it comes to, now let's talk about the fact that when you're talking about e fragrance, you want to smell it. So in the online space, how do you ensure that what you're choosing will actually land as what you imagined it to be?
Okay, so if you like go onto our online store, so you try as much as possible to give a
Describe.
very clear description of what the scent smells like. So you won't just say this one is for men. You have to describe the top notes, the bass notes, you know, and then obviously other people won't understand notes, and then you will go on to it's a woody scent, or it's a, you know, so that someone can, the person reading can sort of have a feel of what the scent smells like. So you try by all means to describe it in detail so that people know what they are buying and what they can expect. You know, so you that's the only way you can describe it to a client. You have to be very detailed in your description.
Yeah. And have you thought about getting into the space of having reselling? Because I think with the big brands that we know, they're actually like they kill it by actually creating a multi-level type of situation where, there's a reselling component to it.
That is actually our whole business. It's for resellers. It's for resellers, but we do allow individuals that want to purchase, but the whole business model is for resellers. So if you go onto our online store, you see there's a whole wholesale page where people can register and get incentives. You know, there's incentives there that are offered. So it's around our business model is centered around reselling.
That's brilliant, actually,
Because
because that's where you get.
we are with the manufacturers, we're a factory, so we are really not the retailers. We are, manufacturers.
Producers,
So,
yeah, you're producing the perfumes and the goods, limited the goods. And then as we go towards a close, I wanted to give you an opportunity to actually kind of give your two cents, if you will, in terms of someone who would want to also start their own brand, start their own fragrance line, get into cosmetics, start a business such as yours. How would you advise them? What are some of the challenges they are to face? How would should they deal with pitfalls, or what pitfalls can they find? What character should they have? I don't know, whichever area you want to focus on, but just advising someone who aspires to get into the same business as you.
So with me, with anything in life, I think you need to have a clear plan of what you want and what you're trying to achieve. Because if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. So you must be very clear about what you want. And then when you have a clear plan, and then then you start doing your research. Okay, what do I need to do? Who do I go to? Who do I talk to? You know, so don't rush the process. It's gonna take time. It's not gonna happen in a month or two, especially if you want to do it properly. Take your time and do research. You know, everything is out there. There's YouTube. There's Pinterest. You can literally do research. There's TikTok. Do your research properly. And first, but start with your plan. Have a business plan or a business model, which is detailed, and then you will always use that as your benchmark. You go back to that every time so that you're not all over the place. You know exactly what you are trying to achieve. So have it, even if you don't get someone to do it for you, maybe you can't afford, because we all know that starting a business, capital is it's a big problem. So, sit down, do it yourself, draft it bit by bit. You know, get on YouTube, find out how you can draft a proper business plan. Like, what are the main headings you're supposed to have? What are you, draft your own business plan and take it from there and have a clear, because if you go to someone else and you don't have a plan, they're going to build that business plan for you. And it might not necessarily be something that you want. So I think you must always have a plan and use that as your point of reference all the time. I mean, we still go back to our business plan that we did, what, 4 years ago? We still open it and we go back to double check, okay, are we still on track?
And also review it at times if it's perverted and stuff like that. Yeah, I think that's really powerful. So, how do we get hold of you? How do we get hold of the business itself? Where do we find you guys? How do we support Luna? Luna? Luna or Luna? Luna
Luna,
Westcott?
Luna,
The
Luna.
not Kosa one.
However you want to say it, I mean, it's okay. Like,
I
it's
thought maybe you're gonna
Luna.
say I thought you're gonna say it's like can be a
Like
child's name
Luna.
that I don't know. Yes.
Yeah, it's Luna. Well, it's Luna Cosmetics. So you can find us on all social media platforms. We are on Instagram and TikTok, and our handle there is Luna underscore cosmetics underscore SA. That's for Instagram and TikTok. And then on Facebook, it's Luna Cosmetics SA with no underscores. And then we also are available on WhatsApp on 082 598 0769. So 082 598 0769. That's where you can inquire, and you can even purchase through our WhatsApp store, because we have a WhatsApp store set up for people that don't want to go online. And then our domain, like online, if you want to search for us, it's www.lunafragrances.com. Yeah, that's how you find us. And
Thank you so much, Nambita, for coming through and having this conversation with us. It has been quite an insightful conversation. We appreciate your time.
thank you for having me.
Awesome.
Thanks. Awesome. Bye.
Bye. Pull up with Ugani Community Radio.